Hey y'all, so for step five, I'm going to show you something that absolutely blew my mind when I first discovered it. I think it's going to blow yours too. And it'll make your workflow just go much faster. As you might have discovered already, it can be pretty tedious to, get the position just right, or the scale, or the rotation. You're kind of adjusting your code, and then you go back and you check your site and you see if you got it right, and it can take some time. So what you can do actually is use a tool called the A-Frame Inspector. And A-Frame, by the way, is the tool we're using. It's kind of like a library of code that we've brought into our project, and it's what turns our HTML into a 3D experience. So we're using A-Frame throughout this. But we can use a tool called the A-Frame Inspector on any page made with A-Frame, and it gives us this visual way to configure the scene. Now, the way to pull it up is open up your project, which should look a little bit more interesting than this by now, but in any case, open it up and hold down Control Alt I. And it will open up this sort of visual, inspector. And I have a mouse, and on the mouse you can right click to pan the camera right or left, up or down. You can left click to rotate the camera, and I can use the scroll wheel to zoom in or out. Now you can select your different entities here on the left. You've got this entity list. And with one selected, you'll see these arrows come off of it. And with these arrows, you can actually drag it where you want. You'll see the position. Right now, I'm moving the position right, and you'll see that value change over here in this sort of property panel. Okay, you can move it up, blah, blah, blah. Now, this doesn't make permanent changes to your scene. It just gives you a way to sort of configure it and see where it should be. And once you know where it should be, then you want to figure out what those values are, right? X, Y, and Z. And you want to make sure you put them back in your code to make those changes permanent. Now, besides position, you have a few other easy widgets to play with. If you look at this toolbar up here, you can see there's also one for rotation. You can click rotate, and then instead of arrows, you'll see these kind of bands around it. So you can rotate things, and then you'll also see one for scale. So if you wanted to scale up your box, you could scale it right up. To scale it up proportionally, grab it from the middle. Right, and scale it up that way. Okay, once you've played around with the inspector, and take a few minutes to do that and make your way around it, let me know if you have any questions, of course. If you want, go ahead and check out my text element. This is like a little challenge. I'm not going to give you too many instructions on. You can just sort of have at it if you want. But play around with this element and see if you can make sense of how it's working, and make another one in your scene if you want that says some message that you want. Right? Notice I just have a few attributes here, and this backslash n is what you can put in to make a line break, just so you know what that's doing there. Okay, so have at it. Check out the A-Frame Inspector, Control Alt I, and then also if you want and have some spare time, play around with text.